as long as you're alive, there's always going to be things that are going well in your life and things that are not going well in your life. And if you dwell on those things that are not going well in your life, it can make you feel unhappy. But if you don't face them, they can grow bigger. You know, a fire that's unattended can become a wildfire and grow out of control. You know, and it's easy to let these things that are going on in our lives feel like they are, make us, if we're not succeeding in something, then we can feel like we're a failure. In the areas we're succeeding, we can feel like, wow, I'm doing well. I'm getting fitter, I'm getting stronger. And then these other areas that when you confront them, the reason that you don't face up to them is because to face up to them makes you feel like I'm failing in those areas. You know, but what we need to realize is that situations and circumstances where we're failing doesn't define us. What defines us is our identity, who we are, who we think that we are, who we know that we are. You know, I am made in the image of God and after his likeness. I am a new creation. The old is gone, the new has come. If we look unto Jesus, who's the author and finisher of our faith, if we look into the word, we can find hope, we can find strength. We can know that it's a challenge, but it can come to pass. You know, where we are right now doesn't mean we're always going to be there. These are challenges and circumstances, no matter how big they are, that will come to pass. And with God's help, we can overcome them. And those tests, those struggles, they can become testimonies. We've heard those sayings lots of times, but they really can. We need to take them to God in prayer. We need to reach out for help. You know, we need to face up to those things and then attack them one step at a time. So I want to encourage you today, whatever it is that you've been avoiding facing up to, begin to face up to it. Take it to God in prayer. Make a decision to act on it today as well. Don't just think about it and think, oh, do something about it soon. Make a decision that today I'm going to take an action to act on facing that thing that you've been avoiding and making a change. You know, for David, he faced the Goliath, but before he faced the Goliath, he said that God helped him to kill the lion and the bear. So let's, by God's grace, face the lion and the bear, so that when those big situations come, that we can face the Goliath as well. I saw this post to one of my friend's statuses the other day. It said, choose your pain. It said you have the choice of the pain of, say, exercise, so that you can be fit and eating the right food so you can be fit and healthy, or you can just eat what you want and then choose the pain of being fat and unhealthy. You can choose the pain of being careful with your money and having the discipline to save and to be careful with your money, or choose the pain of now having a lot of debt and having to deal with that debt and face debtors. You can choose the pain of sacrificing your time to reach out to others and to care for them and find out their concerns, or choose the pain of being, or you're going to be lonely and you'll have that pain instead. So in life, we can choose, you know, which price do you want to pay? If we do something, we can enjoy the good benefits, but it's going to cost something. But if we don't do anything, we're going to pay even more price, but not enjoy the benefits. So choose to do the right things so that you can enjoy the benefits of having done the right things. And I'll see you again tomorrow.